and welcome to another Rubbernecker video. I am so glad that you are joining me today. Now I'm going to use this stamp set here. This is called the Fall Stamp Set, and sorry, the Fall Pumpkins. And this just released newly this month. And I'm going to show you two ways to use this stamp set. Actually, it's going to be, I'm calling it one design, two styles. What I mean by that is if you think about a contemporary design element, the design idea of the design is the same, but the style in which you take the design and create could be so many different ways. So that's what I'm trying to do here. I hope it makes sense as we get into the project. So here what I've gotten done is I've taken this largest pumpkin from this set and I've gone ahead and stamped it using a black pigment ink onto a watercolor cardstock. And then I'm going to take a few different watercolor palettes. Now this palette that I'm using today is from the Ganzai Tambi watercolors. You can use any watercolors you have in your stash, it doesn't matter. I'm going to do a very traditional orange pumpkin. So I'm just, as I said, I just chose a few different shades of oranges and yellows for this pumpkin. And I'm going to take, I just took a, paper towel here that you can see, just so that I can sop up extra water from my brush. And then all I'm doing is I'm dipping my brush in water, laying the water first, and then dropping the colors into it. So I just want to add the yellow tones on the top of the pumpkin, and then I want to add the darker orange tones at the bottom of the pumpkin. So nothing too fancy here. Anybody can do this watercoloring. It does not require any watercoloring experience, nothing. All you do is wet the surface, add water, keep blending if you like it, or don't blend it, let the water do the trick. Here you can see now I'm adding some deep orange color to the bottom of the pumpkin just to create more orangey base into the pumpkin. So I'm going to keep doing this until I am satisfied. I'm going to add the yellow on the top, the orange at the bottom, and keep doing until I like the way this pumpkin color looks. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the brush and I'm going to drip it into water, and I'm going to take away most of the water from the brush, and then I'm going to sop up some of the colors from the center of each of those pumpkin grooves, and that kind of acts that would create some highlight in the pumpkin. And I'm also taking some green color to add some green to the stem. So I haven't done that highlighting technique yet, so because I just want that pumpkin to, the colors to blend a bit more before I can go to that step. And now you can see here I'm just taking some plain water and I'm sopping up off the excess color from the center of the pumpkin to give that white highlight in the bottom. So it's not really a stark white, there's still color underneath it, but it's not as bright as what it was earlier. I hope that's really making sense. It's just very simple watercoloring, nothing too fancy, as I said. Don't be intimidated by this coloring at all. Just play with it, have fun, and then just let the water and the watercolors do its trick on the paper. And now I'm just going to heat set that really well for the next step. And now you can see that the pumpkin is all dried up and that highlight in between, and the color looks very subtle but yet pumpkin-y, right? Okay, so what I want to do next is I want to add some splatter around this pumpkin. So I'm just going to take a black ink palette here, again from the same collection, Ganzai Tambi, and I'm wetting it down. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a fan brush. I noticed that if you want to do splattering works, fan brush really works well. And this is a very cheap fan brush. I have not used anything expensive here. Very cheap student grade, fan brush. And I'm just going to cover up my pumpkin using some paper towel. And then I'm going to tap this black color around the pumpkin, trying to avoid as much as possible not to get the black dots onto the pumpkin. And then I'm going to let it dry. Or maybe no, actually I'm going to heat set it, because I lack patience, obviously. So I'm just going to dry it with my heat tool right here. And then I'm just going to keep it aside while I do the next step. And for that, I want to go to do the sentiments. And so I'm using this die cut here. This is called a friend die. And this friend die has two-step die cuts, dies in it. So there is the friend die set, and then there is the shadow for the friend die set. So, and I'll be using both of them for this particular card. So as I told you, there is the friend die and then the shadow. So I've gone ahead and die cut the friend with some gold glitter cardstock, and also the shadow part for the friend using a vellum cardstock here. And then I'm just going to adhere this friend, gold friend, onto the vellum friend using some glue pen, because it's the quickie pen has a very fine tip and it makes it easier to use that pen over those tiny pieces of the die. And then I'm just going to adhere that onto the vellum cardstock, and you can see how beautiful that looks. And then I'm going to pair this with another stamp set, and this is Kittie Says Friend stamp set. And there's some really nice sayings in this stamp set. I'm going to use "I'm so grateful for our friendship." So I'm going to just stamp that underneath this pumpkin that I use. So I'm just going to place the die cut first, just making sure where I would want that sentiment to be placed. And then I'm going to place that sentiment right underneath the friend. And once I'm satisfied with the way they both work together on the cardstock, so it's a very simple card, you see it. It's nothing too much going on here. Very simple. And you can probably mass produce. You can have Happy Thanksgiving under it. You can say thank you. I mean, this, all you need to do is change the sentiments that you're using. And here you see I've just stamped the sentiment using a black ink. And then I'm going to adhere this friend right over that stamp set. And honestly, there's so many different sentiment stamps that the Rubbernecker store has. You can put anything you want on underneath this pumpkin. And I just decided to do a friendship thank you card with a little bit of fall theme. A really nice card to send to your friends when they're far away during this fall season. And here you can see the completed look of this card. I mean, not the completed look, the image of the stamped image. And then I went ahead and cut the edges about 1/4 inch from all sides. And then I'm going to just adhere this using some foam tapes onto a side folding note card. And I plan to send these cards, definitely. I'm creating two cards. I'm going to send them to my friends who I miss a lot. The reason I was not online for so long was because we moved from Minneapolis to North Carolina in the month of July, and we just bought the house here. And so we were in the process of transitioning and moving and all this fun stuff. And I do miss my friends in Minneapolis. So I know these cards are definitely going to my friends, as I miss them so much during this this season. And I definitely miss the fall colors of Minnesota too. Anyway, while I was blathering away, I went ahead and added some gold sequins onto this card, and that card was done. For my second card here, now this time I wanted to use my alcohol markers, so I went ahead and die cut a Nina Solar white 80-pound cardstock to 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, and then I'm just going to stamp this time three pumpkins, not two but three. And I'm going to do it not horizontal but vertical. Last card was horizontal, this card it's going to be vertical. I can see very similar design, as I said, but I'm just tweaking the way I orient my card, the way I put my stamp set, and the number of pumpkins or elements I use. For the first one, I use just one element, one pumpkin. In here, I'm using two. I want to do some masking, but I want to just kind of figure out where I want to put these pumpkins for my project. So I just lay up. Once I was satisfied with that, I go ahead and I stamped two tiny pumpkins on those white cardstock, and I've created some masks for these pumpkins, and I'm just going to adhere them on each of these pumpkins. So there's one medium size and then one there's a smaller size. So the medium size right now you can see is on the left side and the smaller one is on the right side. And now I'm going to place this large pumpkin and I'm going to stamp using a black ink. Now this black ink pad, keep in mind, is alcohol friendly, Copic marker friendly. You could use Memento tuxedo ink, and that's what helps with it's any dye ink, actually, not pigment ink. Dye ink helps you with Copic markers. So I want to show you what that masking tape was, or masking paper was. It's just a post-it note, which is completely sticky in the back. I got mine from Amazon, and they're cheaper to use, and that's what I use for masking anytime I want to mask. So I've gone ahead and chosen a few different shades of Copic markers. As you can notice, there are no pumpkin colors in there. There's no orange in there. There's nothing. I'm just going to do a very minimal black and white, almost warm gray colored pumpkin. And as I was going to stamp, I noticed that there were a few spots where I had missed stamping this pumpkin. So I just took a black marker and then added back those joining lines. And now I'll start coloring. And coloring, again, nothing too complicated. I added W5. Sorry, I don't know why I did not keep my cap there, but I know later on you will start seeing the cap. This one here is W5. It is, these are warmer colors, so I'm using warmer colors for this pumpkin here, and I'm going to add that wherever I think there would be a shadow. So there are shadows because of these two pumpkins in front of the larger pumpkin, so I'm going to add shadows there. I'm going to also add shadows wherever I think there would be grooves in the pumpkin, and I'm also going to add some extra lines in between those grooves just to add some texture to these pumpkins. And then I'm going to blend the W5 with W3 and the W3 with W1. I had W0 with me too, but I didn't use that because I thought W1 was quite enough. I didn't want to remove, desaturate my colors, so I kept away. I did not use the W0. And I did the same thing for the two other tiny pumpkins composition. And what I did is I took the same colors W5 and W3 and W1, and I added some dots in the darker places of these pumpkins to just create a little bit more texture to a very one dimension stamp. So trying to create it more, make it look more two-dimension. It's nice to add shadows and speckles, all of those elements add so much more to your very simple one-dimension stamp. So here you can see I've finished coloring all the three pumpkins, and for the stem I used YG99 for the darker color and YG95 as a color to blend those stems, just to give a little bit of greenery to this this pumpkin card. So it's a very just three colors, and you will notice the third color that I'm using is more the brown base, and that's actually to ground the pumpkins. And here I realized my large pumpkin needed a little bit more coloring, so I added one more layer of the same colors. And now it's time to add some ground for this pumpkin. So the darkest color I'm using is E27, and that's going to be close to the pumpkin, very, very close, because you can notice the shadow of any object falling on something very close to the object, the shadow is going to be the darkest. So that's the reason I chose the darkest color. And I also want to point out, as I'm laying this ground, you want to lay it horizontal. You don't want your your pen to go vertical or diagonal. You want it to be horizontal, because if you are putting a ground, the ground is underneath and it's going to be horizontal. I hope that makes sense. And then I'm going to blend E27 with E25, E23, and finally E21. And once I was done doing all that, I did the same dot effect on the ground as well. And that was just to add that the ground had some texture to it. It's not, you don't see ground like mud, or when you have dirt underneath something, it's not going to be smooth. There's going to be texture in it. So you want to portray that a bit, though this is not realistic, but still you want to create some kind of realism in your, even the cartoon looking designs. Anyway, here I want to do the same splatter effect, but this time I'm going to add orange splatter, and I'm using Ken Oliver's watercolor paints, and I've got this orange color from his collection. Doing the same thing, dipping my fan brush into the paint, and I'm going to splatter that. And I'm going to not cover my pumpkins this time. I'm going to let that orange kind of go all over. This is just that fall feel, as if the beautiful fall leaves of different colors are falling on the ground and onto the pumpkin. And it's just an imagination of that fall theme. And once I'm done adding that splatter, I am going to add exactly the same sentiment. This time, I did not use the shadow for the friend, but just the friend. And I cut it in an orange color cardstock multiple times, adhered them together, and then added that sentiment underneath the friend. And added some gemstones. Not gemstones, these are sequins in a very like almost silvery, very iridescent sequins. Just adding it to the cardstock, because I didn't want to add any other color to this card. And you can see this card right here. And then I'm going to add this to a top folding note card using some foam tape. And I'm not going to cut the sides on this one. I'm going to keep it exactly the same size as the note card, which is 4.25 by 5.5. And here are the two completed card using that same stamp set. And you can see how different they are in styles, but yet they're so similar in their design. And here's a closer look of those two stamps. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.